Welcome back. We are going to be continuing our painting of the starter set for the Night's Watch by painting our Ranger Trackers that came in this set. So let's get started with our Pale Flesh. Some of that down. Definitely getting better at this. I mean, it is taking lots of practice for the dry brushing their faces to kind of figure out what looks right and what, like, to know, like, what's going to look okay once we get to certain points. Let those dry a little bit because we're gonna try something a little different this time, and we'll go with the black, dark blue gray first. We'll try something different with their heads later. Just gotta pick out those parts that we're gonna be painting. Haven't really looked at these models yet to be like, to plan where the paint's gonna go, so we're just gonna have to figure it out as we go. Looks like it's just going to be the legs for this guy, this sculpt. Oh, no, he's got like a. See, this is his cloak. This is also. No, that's his. He has like an overshirt on, so maybe let's get in here with this sleeve here. Get it from all the angles here. And I think this is probably, yeah, the same kind of deal. I've taken a little break in painting, so painting models this scale. I mean, I just painted a B-wing model that I have had for a while, and I really wanted to paint it, so I got it done and it turned out pretty cool. Maybe I went a little crazy on the weathering though, but whatever. Let's find out what we're gonna. We'll do the horses last, probably. I haven't decided if I'm gonna paint them all the same or what yet, so we'll see. Maybe they got the same kind of shirt on shirt deal going on. Which makes sense, they're in the snow, so. Here. You can't see it from the other side, you cannot. And just his little leg is showing here. This is hopefully going to be a lot shorter video than last week's. Last week we had a lot of guys to paint. This week we only have four, so should be considerably shorter. Shouldn't be 3 hours. But I think those guys turned out really cool. I'm happy with them. And there's like the bread and like the not bread and butter unit. I would say like the they're pretty basic unit for them that will fit into any list. So. We had to get those done, and I'm glad that we did. I got almost all my stuff in now to paint the rest. I have the Heroes 1 box came in. We'll be painting a few guys from there, and then the Crossbowmen came too. I'm just waiting on one more set of Rangers. Not the, they won't be the ones on the horses, though. They'll be the ones on foot, and some attachments to go with these guys. And the Rangers that are on foot, it'll make them pretty powerful units. I didn't buy the attachments box, though. I just bought the guys individually on eBay instead of shelling out for the box. Which, who knows if that was the right call or not. I mean, I might eventually end up having to buy everybody in there. More than the box, probably. Cool, these guys are different poses. It's easier for a 4-man unit for them to do that than a 12-man unit, so I get it. Why the other ones don't have 12 unique poses in them. I have been able to play another game. I won this one this time. I used my crossbowmen, even though they were unpainted. And they went, I think, the whole game pretty much unchallenged, and they were able to harass and keep an enemy busy. So that was pretty great. But I didn't play in person. I played on TTS, Tabletop Simulator, for people that don't know. And it's, you know, the Tabletop Simulator. Thing is pretty good. Let me get the Gulliman's flesh. We're gonna do that for their faces this time. Use a different brush. You don't want to get it all grimy. Our good brush is all grimy. Because allegedly it matters. Yeah, definitely would recommend TTS to anyone who wants to get into this game and isn't sure if they want to buy it, because you can play the whole game on there. You can build your lists online, import them into the game, and the modules and stuff in there are really good. And you don't have to fight with it as much as like I have had to fight with it with the Warhammer 40K one. This one seems like actually better supported better and stuff like that. What I have been doing is painting them and then doing the Reichlin flesh wash over them and then going back over it later at a later point and taking the pale flesh again and just highlighting over it, but I think this just might be a better choice. It has different colors in the hair. I mean, it adds different colors to the skin. I think it might be good. You could even use a white dry brush in the beginning instead of the pale flesh one that we did, but it ends up kind of white, so it pinks it up a little bit more, which is good because we are in the snow. And that way, you know, they get a little pale in there. Now we're going to the browns, this black brown. I'm going to get their shirts now. Since we're only doing four guys, we can take our time and not rush spots and hopefully get less paint on things that we don't want it on, so we don't have to do a lot of touch-up. Hopefully. Hopefully. Let's paint this little... that he's got going on here. This was going to be my second unit I painted. After I painted the heroes, but then I thought I wasn't going to use them, so then I went and painted the Sworn Brothers instead, and then decided that I did want to try these guys out some more. So now I'm painting them for that when I do finally get to play in person again, we'll have a mostly painted army. I mean, at this point, the big block unit is done. We just have to worry about the. After this is done, you just have to paint the veterans, and that's it for the starter set. The veterans are a 12 man unit, so it will be a little longer video when I'm ready to tackle that guy. But hopefully, they're not as posed out as the Sworn Brothers are, though. They're a lot more tighter together, like their pose. So painting it might be easier, but I'm cursing myself right now by saying that. So tune in for that guy to see what happens there, because I don't even know what's going to happen there. So far, I'm doing a pretty good job of not hitting the belt parts, because you know the belts are black on my paint schemes for this guy. we're not gonna have to be doing much touch up, if any. So that's a good feeling to be going into this like that right now. Okay, so we got some leather there. We got his shirt that I just got some on his pants, but that's fine. We'll fix it in a second. That's the back of sit over there. This guy's got a lot of interwoven strappy bits, so it's going to be interesting here. Just pick out those areas the best we can. That, I think that's good. Get his little part that's tucked in under, over his under his belt, and then the spot here. And let's clean up those blues really quick while we're here. Get some there. And then we get some here. Okay. I had to double check that I was recording. I was like, I hit the record button, right? Like a seam in there. A little tight in there. this. Okay, let me see here. What's what? I think that's shirt, which means this would be right there too. It's a little weird in there. Clean that up. Oops, we gotta get his spot here. Is that part of that? Or what is that? We got some globs on here. We don't want that. I think this is more of his armor right here. There. And like in there. And then here. Last guy. He's in a weird pose. Looks like this would hurt. This may be a tunic of some sort on him, but whatever. He can have two different, he can have the same color undershirt on. No one says he can't. See in there. So just get it the best you can. Belly. Then get all of this. Just get the bottom if there's like big chunky bits that are on the bottom of this. And then clean up. The ring there. Cool. Let me just tapped something here that we can just clean up really quick. Just boop. Clean that up. Alright, what now? Usually we would go on to the black. I want to do the bows right now, just because they might get in the way, especially with the hands and stuff. So we'll get the bows and the arrows. We'll use a leather brown for that. Actually, let's do something lighter. Let's do a monster brown, maybe? Yeah, let's do monster brown. That way it'll be more of a contrast of colors. We'll leave the arrow shafts, I think we'll leave them black. I think it's like a blackened wood kind of deal going on. And we'll leave the black leather wraps on these two. The thing about Army Painter paint is it is a lot thinner than Vallejo, so you might have to do a couple coats, or just be good with how it looks when you put it down. Could add a little bit of graininess to the texture of the bow, which is fine. Thank God they didn't like model a string on these. Would be horrendous if I had to deal with that. Like a little bit showing there. There. Just clean it up as best we can. Don't have to get into here because most people won't see it. But if you're crazy like me and get all obsessive over it, just get it now and not worry about it at 3 o'clock in the morning. We did hit his shirt, so let's clean that up while we're here. Like we do, just right there. That helps it stand out a little bit more on the table than just being a black figure. We haven't painted the horses yet, so this is why we haven't done that yet. But don't go crazy. Don't just disregard the horse. Because if you decide to paint black horses, keeping them clean right now is going to save you time later. I say that as I get paint all over the horse. A minefield in there when it's so close to the horse like that. I'd rather be close to their capes because I'm painting their capes. I would prefer it if they were out like this, like super far from everything. It's like, oh yeah, you're not gonna like that one. That one was good because I didn't have to worry too much about hitting anything else on the model. Okay, we're gonna paint the glove black, so we painted this first. So that when we did get stuff on it, we'd be able to paint over it. Got a little messy down there, but we got it, we got it. One more. I like how it dries. It dries to like a nice kind of bone color. There we go. Gets all those guys. While we're here, let's do the saddle just because. We might paint ourselves because this leather brown for like the saddle and the reins. The stirrups and everything, like let's just get all the horsey bits. this leather brown. So then when we go to our black, we can touch up anything that we like, the boots and stuff that we hit along the way, because that's gonna happen for sure. This is weird that it's just like this big open area, but I get it, that's how they keep their model price down, right? You know, if that was hollow, they couldn't necessarily do it all in one piece. Oops, I'll have to fix that too. You couldn't do the whole model as one piece, as a one piece mold. So it would put a lot of, it would put construction either on the people making the models, which increases the price, or put the building onto you, which some people don't like to build models. Let me see, we're hitting the horse pretty hard here with this brown and getting it pretty much everywhere, which is not what we want to do, but seems to be what's gonna happen. Let's keep the reins black just because I can see that going weird, and then especially with how they are one piece like that with this big old floppy piece in the middle, I don't think it would look as good. You don't have to go crazy here. No one's be looking at the bottom of your dude's feet to see if you painted the stirrups under there. And if they are, they're an asshole. They're an asshole if they look there and then they tell you, oh, you didn't paint down there. If they look down there, I mean, it's just curiosity, I guess, but they're the type of people that look at it under a fine microscope and are like, how come you didn't paint down there? And then it's like, you don't want to play with those people. Those people are boring. Just be careful around your rider so you don't mess him up as much as you can. I'm glad I decided to do this now, because this would have sucked to do later. You can see it ruining a lot of other stuff that I've done, instead of just kind of hitting the pants a little bit. So I just have to do some, a little bit of touch up versus a whole lot of touch up. front of the saddle here. You see, like when I primed these guys, I didn't get any paint underneath the horses. Okay, that was ugly. Now we'll give those time, the brown time to dry, before we go on to the black. So what we're gonna do now is the black gray on the heat and the cloaks. Black gray. Someone's riding a motorcycle out, like in the field behind my house. That was dark. It's not dark yet. It's not nighttime yet. can I get? Let's see how far we can get. And then get his hood, which probably isn't part of his cape. It's probably part of his shirt, but now I'm doing it. Edge of it. Ooh, this guy doesn't have fur on his cape. Do you? No, most of them do, except this guy. He's not cool enough. In this one, you can see that the hood is part of the cape, so maybe it is. Who's to say? Make sure we're not hitting parts of the model we don't want to. Can kind of get under there. Here we go. Need to get better at determining how much paint I need to put in the palette, because I end up wasting a lot of paint just because I'm not sure how much to put in there. Also, same thing with the airbrush, but when I was painting that B-wing, I put what I thought was not enough gray into paint it, and it turned out to be enough to do the whole thing. So, still have a lot to learn. Okay, there's that. Now let's go through and touch up all like the pants that we hit. So I have to put a little bit more of that blue-gray in here. make sure not to hit our black gray when we're doing this, and just go through and find those areas that we messed up on, like right here. Just clean that up. That's what's going to be ruined the most on these guys, besides the black, but we haven't even done the black yet, so. Just go through and clean up those lines. See that everything's where it should be. Looking good on that guy. Is it only that one guy that I messed up that bad on? Now we can go into the black. Let's put some black down. Especially like right now, like I said in my previous videos, I want to preserve the black as much as possible because that's the paint that's hard to find right now. For whatever reason. Just look at the feet, clean up any of these lines here, the mane. Any spots that you didn't hit, maybe just tap them. It should dry. Hopefully, as black as they are. Otherwise, they'll be like spotted black horses with black spots. That's a color, right? It's fantasy world. Who's to say what color horses are in a fantasy world? Okay, we also have to do the basic black stuff. Almost forgot about that. So go back through here, look at their belts and buckles and stuff, and then like the arrows too, and get those to be black. They turned out pretty good. Like that was when I was fresh and bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. Oh yeah, and the keep missing spots, like the little black wraps on the bow, which look pretty good on that guy, so we're gonna leave it. Then clean up this guy. Paint the bellies while I'm there. How does this look? This looks good. We didn't hit anywhere else. Should we do get right there? Let's clean that. Get some brown on there. Good. Let me get the furthest one. Oops, I went into the wrong color, like I do. I was going too fast. We are doing black right now. Good thing that goes over that color, like no problem. in there because we got some other colors on there. Okay, so far so good up here. Don't know how I got the paint in there. It's probably splashing around too much. So we'll have to get that with the... with that dark brown that we use. Take the rest that's on the brush here and just kind of ghetto dry brush the horse. With it. Just to there we go. Let me check this guy and see how he's drying to see if I'm gonna it's fine. The differences in color between the blacks isn't noticeable. Cool. You have to go back on this guy to get his little... I'm putting him to the side so I remember. I still won't remember. What was I doing on this guy? I was done, so I was like, oh, I'm gonna do good on this guy. Check his belt. Get his furs. Because I noticed on my other guys that I didn't clean this up on, it kinda looks weird. Darken it up a little bit. I messed up on this side a lot. There we go. There it is. There's my mistakes. Just clean up his hand here. Let's go here, let's clean up that little spot that we got on this guy right here. Okay. Now let's switch to a little smaller brush. And we're going to do the hair on them with our black brown. Get those beards and everything. And we'll move on to the metallics. And then we should be pretty close to done at that point. Go in there and pick out their features here, like their beard and stuff, and then just hit them with the brown. Can we use some of the white in the hair to give them like a old manny look? his hair figured out. We just gotta get in here. Especially since he's covered with a hood, you don't have to be crazy about it. This guy's face looks a little bit more bitchy. Got a bowl cut? I mean, I guess their barbers aren't that great on the wall, right? So maybe I'll just have them with like a goatee. Because I don't want to ruin it. And this can solidify him as the guy that's not that great. Let me just get a little bit closer here. Is Lloyd his Christmas hair painted? Here we go. And then the last guy. Just try to keep still. You'll be able to get there. Here we go. Now let's get the metallics with our, there's a different brush for this, because apparently that ruins it too. So let's get this brush, get our, we'll use silver because it's like there, no, we'll go for the gunmetal first. We'll get the arrow tips with the silver, but the buckles and stuff will get with this, so we have to look for those first. Ooh, this is gonna be messy if I use this brush. I can see that happening. Let's go into this brush. These are cheap anyway, so. Got some little studs here. We can do the things on the horses too, but we'll just treat those as like blackened steel because we don't want to get too close to the horse right now, because I mean it's just a lot more fiddling that we'd have to do if we mess it up, so not even gonna do it. Check this guy. So this guy's got some buttons on his shirt. He's got a buckle here, some more studs. got a buckle here. Some more studs. Some studs on there. A little locky thing. Right there. Right there. It looks like stud on the belt. But he didn't have one over there, so. Okay. Now we go on to the silver for the arrowheads. You can use the shitty brush for this because we're not trying to be precise here. It's just one spot. It's not the end of the world. It's pretty far out from the rest of the model, so you don't have to worry as much. So let's go here. Take this. Silver on the arrowhead. Them too close together. That's what's making. Oh, he doesn't have arrows out, so easy for him. Okay, now we get the furs, the little extra bits on the fur. We get our German camo beige World War II out. And our brush. And then we're going to look for the hairs on the, some like hairs on the tips of these boots here. But really quick, while we're here on this guy, I see that I missed some cape painting right here. Does he have? Go back to the khaki color on the boots. Looks like he has some on his, I know his arms are just the studded ones that I didn't dot, but that is fine. This guy. can dry brush their cloaks with the same color. Just gotta be careful. That guy doesn't have a cape because he's not cool. Here we go. Now we can take our black wash, hit the models with it, and be done. Just hitting the brush off every once in a while to make sure that if it is wet, we're not getting any of that stuff onto the model. Stay away from the faces with the wash. The wash already did its job on the, we already hit our faces earlier, so don't have to go crazy there. And we can do one more thing after this too, so stand by, we're not just done. The dry brush the horses. I didn't even get that guy's cape, I don't think. So I'll have to go back in a second. And mainly what we're doing with this wash is just bringing the colors down to a darker tone. That's all I want. I don't want to go crazy with the washes on these guys. Let me check. His cape, no, I didn't get his cape, so. Just go in there, boop. Last guy. Back. Alright. Nice. Okay. I gotta dry brush the horses. I forgot about that part. Let's get our medium sea gray. And this, we gotta be a little careful because we have the wash now. In play, so that could mess this up a bit if we touch it, so try not to touch it. Ooh, that was a lot. It's a bit much, but whatever. We'll paint the grass later that's on the base when we do the basing and stuff, and we figure out like how we can match it to the grass tufts that I have. It's only gonna get lighter though as we keep going through all these other models with it, so just keep going. See, we hit the wash right there. So just get your finger on it and then pull it off. The farther away it looks better on the horses, so that's what we want. We want tabletop distance. Find where the muscles are on the horse and then paint in the direction of the bumps on it or against the direction, and then it'll pull it out and define it more. Is our ranger trackers, I think is what they are. I don't remember off the top of my head. So we get ourselves some cool horse archers / warriors. Get the turn table out here. Thanks for watching as always, and please like and subscribe. See you next time.